Slaughterhouse the Dog. Yeah. It's a bit though, dude.
Living in my tent outside where you guys are camping now, I was kind of in the chicken coop area. And then it was getting to be late October and it started raining a lot. It was getting cold and the tent was taking on water. And so I went into the bunk room because the bunk room was empty. But then Art was coming to do some stove testing. So they're like, Ryan, you got to get out. You know, Art's paying a lot of money to be here. You got to give him the bunk room. You know, Art was here yesterday. So I took everything and put it in the car. So everything I owned was in the car. And then I went to Eugene for Halloween, and someone stole the car. So the only thing I had was, well, I was borrowing a Halloween costume. It wasn't. So I was like, I didn't care about the car. It wasn't my car. I didn't care about all my possessions. They're just material possessions. But all the work that I had done was on like a couple flash drives in my notebook. I had just hundreds of hours of work, and I was devastated because I was like, all the work is gone. I can't redo it all. And then so a few weeks later, the car turned up, and the only thing left in there was my notebook and flash drives. And so, it was such a valuable lesson for me. It's so easy to just take a minute to back up your work. And so I okay, so just to deal with some logistics before I begin. So when I was here, I participated in a game known as train chasing. So the train goes by, and anytime it goes by, no matter what you're doing, you have to stop and go outside, and then basically there's an ungated crossing right over there, so the train has to slow down to 20 miles per hour. And so that means you can actually, sometimes you could catch it and touch it. And so I would wait for the train to go by, and then I would run after it and see if I could catch it, depending on how fast it was going. So it's pretty fun game. It's a story I've been until now to tell you, because every time the train has gone by this week, you've just been staying there like an idiot. You've been running after it. Okay, let's get started. So Adam was talking about how you could like get kind of a registration waiver if you volunteer.